It's almost like your husband. The next man who comes, like Marianne, they say, come on. You have to start learning everything again from scratch. And let me tell you what I thought. If I got a new section, we already have close to 400 missionaries. I will be new. The person will be new. I will be learning. The person will be learning. The people out there do not know the new person I will bring. It will be good organization, but it will bring relationship. If I keep Marie, she can be only the missionary. Because she used to do it. It will provide something they can be familiar with. But I decided to make a change. Instead of calling Sister Marie my section, I told her that Brazaka is home. She is not my section. She cannot be my section. She can never treat me like that. I don't even expect her. Relationships are not transparent. What somebody meant to this person, I will never meet that person. But that is why I need her. I need her to bring a certain service which I cannot bring. If I'm going to, suddenly I have about 400 co-workers whom I have not been related to. They may not have any connection to headquarters. But if she remains, she can maintain contact between a new leader and the whole cohort. So I told her that she is the section of world congress. She is not Brad Theodore's secretary. She has become the secretary of world congress. Working in the leader's office. She can organize my trips because she has been used to organizing. Then I don't lose her contacts with traveling agents, with airlines, with all the chaplains. If I take my own section, that person will have to learn, take the same time that she took to learn. And I will waste time. Then I took Sister Margaret, who was like a daughter to brother, and who loved me very much. And I asked her to become my personal secretary. So that with her, I can start building the kind of personal things that a man should have on his own secretary. That kind of thing cannot exist in union man. But to lose marriage, we will kill the when I see the younger men around church who are coming into the ministry now, and I see the massive projects in church, the University of Prayer, of Knowing and Serving God coming in, if Anna remains the secretary of Nigeria Congress as a co-worker to Brahma, it will save for Brahma a normal. But if Brahma tries to make her into his personal section, he will pass. He will die. He will walk out. Because Brahma's way of walking is not my way of walking. Just like Brahma's way of walking is not my way of walking. But there will be a continuity. If Anna continues to call the missionaries the way she used to call them when I was there, it produces. Anna will become like a cement, a melting cement between the older missionaries and Brahma, and will cause Brahma less effort. And he will make less effort in public relations. But it takes humility to know that I need others. Not just need others to do what I want them to do, but that others can bring in what it may take me a long time to bring in. To expect organizationally things that ought to come organically. To expect by authority to derive that which should come by relationship is a part of them. If I am the leader, I can call any missionary. But the truth is that there is something like half of me, people are used to relating to somebody. If too many people disappear, there is a feeling of insecurity in the ministry. So Maria to me, world conquest leader. At the beginning, she herself thought that I wanted to make a world conquest leader as my way of rejecting her. But with time, she has understood. She has really come to love me very much. But I keep telling her that I will never be able to have what I want. And I keep pointing out to her that sometimes she behaves in a certain way, the way she has been used to behave with her. And I tell her, I have no problem with that. But that is my father. I have no problem with that. But I need her as secretary of the ministry. And gradually she has come to accept. Because she sees now that I am totally sincere and I have no intention to push her or reject her. Isaac has been there. But one thing I have learned, Isaac has gone into church planting. Isaac has gone into all kinds of things. I think he's the most, he's the jack of all trade missionary in the ministry. I think he will be a fabulous administrator. There are many, many small things that Brahma needs to do. When they will start building in the World University of, in the University of Knowing and Serving God, if at this stage he has to measure cement, count money, and do everything through his beautiful wife, he will collapse. It is reducing the ministry to be something very ridiculously small. People need to come on board even to make him a big man. Who understands what I'm saying? There are critical needs for people to come on board to make him a human. Because if he continues to give attention to certain details, he will want it to remain big to smallness. When we finish getting that land, somebody needs to look for Mega and needs to be a Hausa man. To look for Mega, arrange for caterpillars, run around, somebody to jump around doing everything and present you something that you all can discuss. Somebody you can trust, and somebody you can respect, and somebody you can correct with humility. He doesn't have that kind of person. And Daniel, that Brahma is transforming into an administrator, does not have the gifts of administration. Daniel should be a ministry assistant to Brahma. Somebody to help Brahma with teaching some of the basic lessons. But Daniel is forced to do many administrative things for which he has no aptitude. It has amazed me that in the last 6 years, Abraham has not begged Isaac and Adam to come back. I beg the bullet of Israel. Because I know that it takes a long time to build people. So I don't want to lose the results. When Brother has built somebody for 10 something years, and then you lose that person, then you have lost a lot. You have lost 10 something years of somebody who has been built. For me, that's great loss. It is easier to correct somebody who already has a long history than to take somebody when the work is already very big to begin to train the person again. There are some things that cannot work. The director of administration in headquarters, when I first went to Cameroon, some people in, I used to hear that some people gathered, they were so scared with my coming to be leader that they were doing 7 days past that God was dealing with me. When I asked the Lord what to do, the Lord told me, forget it, those are childish insecurities. Say, with time, as you reassure them, they are your father's people. They have nowhere else to go. Reassure them. Don't begin to feel when you hear that somebody has taken a 7 day pass against you, and then your liver begins to boil. Brethren, the issue is you may be angry, but can you afford to lose 10 years of training? You may be looking at what is negative. What of that which is positive? Just a little positive attitude, a little maturity, a little patience. A little forgiveness. Is that too much? And then you have a great investment. Then you save 30 something years of training. The young people who are building houses in headquarters, when I give them money, they waste it. When I buy equipment, they destroy them. When I scold them, they will change for 5 minutes. Then they get back to just me spoiling things. But the truth is, I have been sleeping on. That's how you have trained house servants, house girls. If you are always dismissing your house girls, it is your children that will suffer. Because you will always have new people to be. Instead of having one set of walls which you can do in this house here, so that you make sure that it is not repeated in your children, you now have 7 house here and you have 7 categories of sins to deal with in your children. Is that not stupidity? Just God be patient. And who are those? If you keep one set of house here, then you study the house again and you know that they are all this. Her sins are like this, her faults are like this. So when you are watching your children, you make sure that they don't pick up those things. When you change that one, you need to study the next house again for all her faults. Then by the time you are correcting those ones, the former faults are seen in your children. New faults are entered. Then you change another house again, new faults. Why are you so foolish? You may be showing that you are a big madam, but you are damaging your children. Because there is no continuity. When Anna was praying, I wish that Anna was in church. If she would pray 8 hours in the church, house of prayer for all nations, without the prayer topic being controlled by Sister Lama, because she already has a big burden of our own kind. And that gradually Isaac will build his house. dangerous.
And be available. A man must have people come on board to make him a new man.
I am hungry for people. If it's better on me, I will just carry grandma to Yahweh. To Bedouin. I make him assistant principal of the School of Lawyers and Law. And by in 1 year's time, all of you will be able to enter the internet and answer this and get your first degree from all the way books. We'll produce them into multiple choice. And Rama will mark them very simply and send by computer and by section. And he will be the teacher of 10 million. People don't make, if you rebel against him and if you are too strong for him, like baby said, the sons of the rear are too strong. You know, David said, you sons of the rear, you are too strong for me. If you brethren are too strong for grandma, I just carry it. Instead of producing the 40,000 here, I can call you to give us 100,000 graduates. 100 million graduates. This is an internet generation. And it will be war. That is the teachable. That's true. And will make him in keep him in better health. I did not take him away from here because there will be no continuity for my work as a missionary. Then I would have wiped away the total foundation of my own work as a missionary. But I'm looking for deep humility that needs men and the power to work with even those who are different. Who understands a bit of my brother? I have a lot of people on my team who are very different. Even though we are sitting there breaking bread there, they are watching me and comparing me to brother. And I'm aware that they are doing it. But that's natural. If I was them, I would also be doing the same thing. When you have known a very charismatic leader and you have a new leader there, is it not natural to always be comparing them? It's natural. Why not be patient? All I can keep telling them is, oh, brethren, be patient. Oh, I am no brother. People just help me so that all of us together, we may compensate for his going. If you beg long enough, they will love you very deeply. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was Brother who taught me the fundamental character of every intercessor is that he begs God and begs men. The inability to beg men is the failure in the call to intercession. Intercession is begging God, and the life of the intercessor is begging men. As messengers, as co-workers together with God, we beg you not to receive the grace of God. Intercessors beg God for men, and they beg men for God. Failure to beg men is the love of authority, not the intercessor's passion for men's goodness, for men's welfare. Love makes us. There are many mothers that beg their children, not to, my my daddy, don't do like that, no. Daddy, stop it, don't call my little daddy. My little prince, don't do like that, no. Yes, no. Hey, I'm proud of you. Oh, who has said mothers always pray? Is it loss of authority? Are they begging because of themselves?
They're praising the child for the child's
parenthood best. Not because they are in need, but because they want to save you. Some of you are suffering some poverty by choice. Because there is so much that you do. There's so much that you want to do. Because to start that massive university of prayer of knowing and serving God, to develop curriculum, to pay the price to return, and then so many practical things. For a personality that is not given to practice. I'm the one I'll be looking around. And I'm begging. Last month, the leader of the Southwest province told me that they are sending four masons, four builders to Kume to pay their transport, pay their money, and let them save Kume and build. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I called one brother. He's a big director in the cotton industry in Cameroon. I told him that we need to register our agricultural department with the Ministry of Training. I told him that only he knows the Minister of Agriculture. I told him, go and get me the letter, the official registration. I said, register a school, an agricultural school, so that we can recruit people to train them. It is what we learned when this school came back from where they went to train for that some guy. We said, what we register is school, so that with that school we can own a large amount of farmland and develop the agricultural department. You need registration. This is brilliant. He went walking to the minister's office, told him that I need a registration for a school, an artisanal school of agriculture. The minister asked him, for who? He said, for me and for some of my people. The minister asked the secretary to type all the information. Normally, you have to publish long dossier. Then there will be a commission to study it before they sign. The minister signed the official registration before asking him to compile the document. Because the minister said, I don't know whether the president will change me by next year. So better, let me sign it. Then you go and hurry. Hurry and look for the documents. So we got the registration before furnishing the documents. Because I can beg the right person who can do it. You think if I enter the office of the minister and I tell him, hello minister, I am Archbishop, anointed of God, full of the Holy Ghost and with fire, and I have blessed you. Now sign me a decree. You think the minister will sign? Because I am anointed. Does he know me?
No.
He does not know me. So there are things I can do. And if you can see somebody who can do it, then you bet you. That is one principle of life. When you were praying, I just told myself what you were wasting. You and I think I was wasting in the intention. He's telling me to give you new direction. But I also ask myself, I cannot command you to go to church. It is only Brahma who can lead you. It is not an official appointment. Do you get the reference? It's not organigramic. It is not, this is the leader of the Nigerian ministry. You people are deputy leaders assigned to. It doesn't work that way. It is a sense of need. A sense of need. If I was a man, I would just go and ask you, Pastor, you know many other people. I know some people. Come, let's work together so that we peel off the gap as much as possible. And call Isaac and say, look, this thing is between us. It's off us. Let's get this thing working. And Isaac will not have to be struggling to become a church planter. And then I will send Isaac to study masonry. That's what you study in polytechnic. Also. What did you study? But we need, that is about the accounting side. We need to send you to study. Anna is an architect. So at least all the architecture that Anna has run away from in the world, with our work now, she would have been there providing the architecture while Isaac runs around and is the legs of all of Makadapo's legs. Makadapo's legs, Makadapo's eyes, Makadapo's hands. But it takes a certain deontology of relationship, mutual respect, mutual love, teamwork, not a formal relationship, top bottom. Fellowship can achieve what authority. But if you were there, if your house of prayer at least would be reinforced with faith. And then I can have a clear future to even visit twice. To be the house in the headquarters. Because I didn't want them to take it to headquarters. In the house, I'll just have sent him to a buy land near the plot. Build his house. And buy big land. To start feeding every many people. It is called salvation. But in that respect, Brahma is a bit like Brahma. When you give Brahma work and you send people, if he does not control it himself, he will not be at peace. To trust other people and to allow them to make mistakes, he cannot do it. One of our little friends wanted to buy a car. He is always traveling with me. He told that our friend wait, that when he will come back, the two of them will go and look at the car and inspect it. And say, we are always traveling. He has a young mechanic friend whom he trusts, called Julius, you know, his Polinos. I said, why do you not send Polinos to go and inspect the car? So that when you come back, somebody gives you a report and then you take a decision. Then you see him must do it. If it is not his own eyes, no eyes that can. It is a sickness of lack of leadership. It's a great limitation. It means that somebody wants to do so much, but he ends up doing so little.
because he's hindered by distrust of others. And by too much faith in himself. What I don't do by myself, I have no confidence that it will be well done. I don't do that. I deliberately allow people to do things knowing that they will do it worse than I can do it.
In fact, when I called some of the builders and I told them to draw their plans, by nature, I have good eyes. I have architectural aptitudes. I even study basic architecture. So when I come and look at the boys, I clap on them, I give them coke, even though I can see that they have not lined. Well, not straight. I can see that the wall is not straight. And I am ready to endure a house whose walls are not straight. While those young people achieve something that will give them the confidence to become better. That will run them down until I will end up having nobody. Who understands me? I have a choice. I can run them down. I can tell them to look at that wall. It's not straight. One wing and the cracks will be there. I can tell them, look at this, look at this. I can just land there and with my eyes, see them fall. When I have finished teaching them that they are nothing, who will be able to tell me? I will stop traveling to preach to come and settle down to this. And secondly, when I show them that I have offers for me, will they take initiative? Everything will wait for me to come and say, now take the next step. Then when they take that one, they will wait until I come and tell them, take the next step. And then they will wait when they take that step until I come and tell them, move your next leg. And that legs tell me, how far will we go? If I do like that, Brazak died, and I asked Brazak's son-in-law, Rafi, I told him, go to India. I gave him the names of Brazak's friends in India, and I told him, go and greet them, and tell them personally that Brazak has come. And walk out with some of them, especially with this one, how we can continue Brazak's work in India. For the last 5 years, I have sent him to India 3 times a year, and I have not gone. I know many of his faults. I know many of his limitations. And finally, he found a leader. And the man has come into the ministry, and in 3 months, he has 58 missions. And a walk of approximately 4,000. So you see, brother, I look at far as succeeded in India by trusting somebody who will not do as much as I have done. He has taken 5 years to do what I may have taken 3 years. But by having him do like that, he has been trained. It means that I can allow him to go and minister in a number of other places from what he has learned. That is my work and increase is what I can do. I have sent one of the missionaries in West Africa to 19 countries to preach. And I am telling him knowing that he has a devil on his head. Because everywhere he preaches, he makes as if that nation is a part of his empire. He doesn't release any missionary from his personal clinic. When he ministers to you, he colonizes you. I'm serious. And sometimes he starts directing the funds to his own country, not longer to women. I have watched him do it. Then I will call him and tell him, you are a man. He will bury you. Then I can knock out the, I will tell him, you are like Haman, the son of Haman. You use my name to build your name. I tell you, when you teach him like that, after 1 year, the lesson will finish. Because I believe that he's a good guy. He just needs to be delivered from personal ambition. And if he discovers that I don't have the insecurity to block him from going to places because he sees he may do something for advancing his own name. Simply because, you know, those lepers that were stealing after the Syrians had come, they stole and then they went and hid. Then they stole again, then they went and hid. When they wanted to steal the third time, they said, oh, look, bros, this is so much. Please, brother, would you allow people to steal 2 times until they return? The third time, if they think it so much, they will repent. Say amen. The other one told him, the other brother said, oh, brother, this thing is very much of. Even if we go 10 rounds, we will not finish it. Let's go and tell the king, because if we continue to see like something terrible may happen to us. Who has read the story? Allow people to be bad in it so that you may save them. But if you control everything, you will end up having no money. I have made some choices. I take certain gambles. I gamble. I can destroy the work in the whole nation by the kind of person I send. That's a risk. And it's a risk that has already happened. There are some 2 or 3 nations in which we have damaged the work there by the person we sent them. But it is still better to shame
us. Hallelujah.
In the next 2 years, I want to have 100 assistants. 100 people can do what I can do. Brahman is going to be one of my assistants for the school of knowing and serving God. I want to use his gifts beyond the narrowness of Nigeria. Brahman is going to be one of my assistants. I already have 3 ministries that are shortlisted for Brahman. I thank God, I thank the Nigerian Air Force for retiring him while he is this strong. He is a nation opener. We shall plan for him to open other nations, more other than Pakistan. Secondly, he is a general. I shall plan, and he planted an assembly in the airport base when he was in Enugu. I want him now, what he did spontaneously out of love for Jesus, I want him to now sit down as a general, ask for permission to preach in all the officers' mess all over Nigeria and make disciples, bring in a certain caliber of people into the work. What was once done spontaneously, now we plan it now as ministry in an organized way. Part 2.
Clap for me. You have a very precious person, and if you don't know how to use it, the person, you can have treasures there, and you don't even know how to use the treasure.
Yes.
He's not an evangelist. But this, what he did in the Air Force base in Enugu, that was the hand of God upon him. Now that he is free, why should he not do it? How many Air Force bases are there all over the nation? Do you think a retired general will ask for permission to preach in the officer's base in any Air Force base in the nation and over the people? They are not refused. He should go to preach where his value is acknowledged. When they know his value, because they know that this is an air commodore. So that when he enters, the people start standing at attention. Say amen. So we hear the gospel very well. Even respect will force them to hear the gospel. That is the best environment for you to preach the gospel. He should not waste his time to read so like the rest of you. If he goes to the street, I used to carry my disciples to the street, especially the proud ones. When Daddy Okoro became my disciple, he used to say, all churches apart from CMFI are not serious. So, to cure him of all the criticism of other churches, I took him out for personal evangelism in the quarter. That's the best way to cure of our religious people from too much pride. We landed in position. Who is there? Hello? We are pastors and missionaries. We would like to share the gospel with you. Holy shit. I'm hungry, doctor. This man, the fire will go cut off my mouth. They don't want the gospel. I said, you're man. So, since you believe, you have never had any persecution written in your book of suffering in heaven. Thank God for this insult that will be recorded at least in your book of suffering in heaven. What it means is that Jesus says, when they reject you in this house, go to the next house. Oh, yeah, let's go to the next house. Go to the next house. By the time I have carried him to be thoroughly insulted, in many houses. His silence is hard. That's the best way to transform. When we inherit religious people, as disciples, people who have been to many churches, and you want to cure them very fast, to overthrow all the plenty religion they have, carry them out of personal evangelism. No for crusade. No, not for crusade. House to house evangelism. Or street evangelism in the marketplaces. I tell you, when the people have insulted them very thoroughly, you see, out there on the street, you cannot say, I am senior librarian in the University of Nevada. You know, their rank does not matter then. When you even say, I am a missionary, they say, only. You want to come and spy our house in order to come back and see me tonight. Only. Your rank does not matter then. I tell you, personal evangelism can wash you of all your greatness. Praise the Lord. Only the anointing of the Holy Ghost will follow you on the road. True or false? That's the way I used to cure those who are very religious. I carry them to the street. Then my work is easier. After that, my work is easier. I allow unbelievers to insult them until I will not be the one to insult them.
If I've never taken you down to the street for personal evangelism, maybe I need you. So that they should give you some thorough insult until you become a Christian. Say amen. The last thing I want to say, then we'll go on break. I have applied what I shared with you before from this John chapter, from this 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I've applied it. I am doing a test application in the church in Douala. Our church in Douala has about 7,000 members. When I went from Nigeria, there were about 35 elders or bishops. Of the 35, 12 were already ordained by brothers. So after teaching them for 3 years, I dismissed all the other elders except the 12. Because I told them, for me to ordain anybody as an elder, he must also be an overseer. That means you must have the work of others that you are overseeing. So I told them, every overseer must have a minimum of 400 people. So that I can be sure that you are overseeing the work of 4 leaders of 100. Then we'll lay down. So that the word elder and bishop does not become meaningless. I gave them 2 years. They did do it. So I sat. I told all of them to go back to their former elders who had recommended to become elders and work with them. So they formed what they call families. So we told the families, you are free to meet. Plan your conquest of the city. From the offerings, tithes and offerings that come from your, all the tithes and offerings from all your families, that from these 12 elders, all the tithes and offerings will get to the office of the leader, that's the coordinating leader, Brahman Patele. When they all get there, the financial secretary will divide the tithes and offerings from all the families into 75% for the whole church. And 25% for that family. From that 25%, they are to break bread. And the elder is to be put on a salary. And if they want to build a hall, they are to plan to build their hall from that 25%. But I told them that I'll give them 1 year. 1 year of giving all the elders, all the 12. 100,000 francs yearly, that's 35,000 naira, as allowance for all the 12 elders. And I told them, I'll give you 1 year to make sure that your family, those under you, that the 25% is above the 100 I'm giving you and enough to break bread. And as your church grows and as the offerings grow, the 25%, we shall increase your salary based on for that 25%. As of now, some families, their 25% is almost 2 million. While some families, their 25% is about 60,000 francs. When December comes, we shall stop the subvention. Those whose 25% is about 2 million, I will put them on a salary of 5 million. So that I may obey this passage. You shall not muzzle an ox while it is treading the corn. It means that they have a lot of work. I have not yet told them So if you have your friend there in Douala and you told them, you will be the one who cut them out. When January comes, I will have a retreat again. I will give instructions to the financial sector that those who 25%, who are going to be the president, those who 25% is above 2 million, the salary of the head of the family, that the elder, will be 500,000. The 75% that they put for the whole church, I told them to divide that one into two. 60% of that 75%, they are to send to Kume for World Congress. 40% of that 75%, they are to keep for the conquest of the city of Douala. That means for allowances and buildings and development. So, the total, if the total of the 100%, 25% for the family, that for that local, the locality and all those people, then another 30%. For city conference, and approximately 45% for work. What? That is what I would like to do in Nigeria. I wanted to start it in Nigeria. Because that is the Bible means for the support of the worker from the church. We have mentioned other means of support. This is support from the churches. From the churches. With the support from the churches. The support from the churches should be tied to the work that has been done. But the support from the churches, you are not the one who collects it, saying that you are the Levite. Then you collect it and swallow it, it will kill you. Because you have already stolen the ministry by stealing all the money. If the money belongs to the whole ministry and then you use all of it, then you are just lying that you are selling my fellowship. The truth is that you have started your own ministry while using us. That's why you use all the money. If the money was the money of our ministry, will you use all of it without asking our permission? If it is our ministry, then how come you are using all the money? Who gave you the right for it? So you are a thief. Shall God bless thieves? Does God bless holy thieves? The sons of Eli, they were called Hophni and Phinehas. Were they blessed? They were judged. They were judged for touching the offering. And any of the missionaries who does not fear touching the offering will be judged. They touched the offering and they touched the women. And God told them, what will happen to you will be a sign. Don't touch the offering, because one day you will touch the women. Hophni and Phinehas will judge for touching the offering. And for touching the women. The women who will worship. That's what I've said. as the Lord blesses, I am going to do it increasingly. In those churches where the leaders are disciplined and where they are, where they function under authority, there are some churches that don't even care about us. So if they don't ask my opinion, or if they don't need my leadership to guide them, I will not trouble them. I will allow them to continue eating the money until they burst with it. God's money is not one of the things anybody should touch. I don't follow anybody who is eating God's money. You will be sorry he ever touched God's money. Your children will become money. God normally should bless your children so that when you are older, they will take care of you. When you start touching God's money, your children will become normal. God will make sure that the way you treated God as his child, you were God's child, and you took your father's money, you will see your children never send you anything. What you sow, you shall see. Who has understood me? Practice it. It will take a long time. But one day you shall see it in your children. Instead of sending you something, they will eat. Praise the Lord. And then I can have a clear future to even be statewide, to build a house in the headquarters. Because I didn't want to take it to headquarters. Build a house. I'll just have sent him to go and buy land near the plot. Build his house. And buy big land to start feeding every many people. It is called silence. But in that respect, Brahma is a bit like a Brahma. When you give Brahma work and you send people, if he does not control it himself, he will not be at peace. To trust other people and to allow them to make mistakes, he cannot do it. One of our little friends wanted to buy a car. He is always traveling with me. He told that our friend to wait, that when he will come back, the two of them will go and look at the car and inspect it and say, where? We are always traveling. He has a young mechanic friend whom he trusts, called Julius, you know, his Polinos. I said, why do you not send Polinos to go and inspect the car? So that when you come back, somebody gives you a report and then you take a decision. But you see, he must do it. If it is not his own eyes, no eyes that can. It is a sickness of lack of leadership. It's a great limitation. It means that somebody wants to do so much, but can't succeed. Because he's hindered by distrust of others. And by too much faith in himself. What I don't do by myself, I have no confidence that it will be well done. I don't do that. I deliberately allow people to do things knowing that they will do it worse than I can do it. In fact, when I called some of the builders and I told them to draw their plans, by nature,
I have good eyes. I have architectural aptitudes. I even studied basic architecture. So when I come and look at the boys, I clap for them, I give them coke, even though I can see that they have not lying. Was not straight. I can see that the wall is not straight. And I am ready to endure a house whose walls are not straight. While those young people achieve something that will give them the confidence to become better. That will run them down until I will end up having nobody. Who understands me? I have a choice. I can run them down. I can tell them, look at that wall. It's not straight. One wing and the cracks will be there. I can tell them, look at this, look at this, look at this. I can just land there and with my front eyes, see plenty more. When I have finished teaching them that they are nothing, who will be able to help me? I will stop traveling to preach to come and settle down with you. And secondly, when I show them that I have capacity, will they take initiative? Everything will wait for me to come and say, now take the next step. Then when they take that one, they will wait until I come and tell them, take the next step. And then they will wait when they take that step until I come and tell them, move your next leg. At that rate, tell me, how far will we go? If I do like that, Brazak died, and I asked Brazak's son-in-law, Rafi, I told him, go to India. I gave him the names of Brazak's friends in India, and I told him, go and greet them, and tell them personally that Brazak has come. And work out with some of them, especially with this one, how we can continue Brazak's work in India. For the last 5 years, I have sent him to India 3 times a year, and I have not gone. I know many of his faults. I know many of his limitations. Then finally, he found a leader. And the man has come into the ministry, and in 3 months, he has 58 missions. And he walked approximately 4,000. So you see, brethren, I look at if I have succeeded in India by trusting somebody who will not do as much as I have. He has taken 5 years to do what I may have taken 3 years. But by having him do like that, he has been trained. It means that I can allow him to go and minister in a number of other places from what he has learned. That increases my work and increases what I can do. I have sent one of the missionaries in West Africa to 19 countries to preach. And I am telling him, knowing that he has a devil on his head. Because everywhere he preaches, he makes a determination, is a part of his empire. He doesn't release any missionary from his personal clinic. When he ministers to you, he colonizes you. I'm serious. And sometimes he starts directing the funds to his own country, not longer to women. I have watched him do it. Then I will call you and tell you, you are a man. He will bury you. Then I can knock out the, I will tell you, you are like Haman, the son of Haman. You use my name.
to build your name. I tell you, when you teach him like that, after 1 year, the lesson will finish. Because I believe that he's a good guy. He just needs to be delivered from personal ambition. And if he discovers that I don't have the insecurity to block him from going to places because he sees he may do something for advancing his own name. Simply because, you know, those lepers that were stealing after the Syrians had come, they stole and then they went and hid. Then they stole again, then they went and hid. When they wanted to steal the third time, they said, oh, look, bros, this thing is so much. Please, would you allow people to steal 2 times until they repent? The third time, if the thing is so much, they will repent. Say amen. The other one too, the other brother said, oh, brother, this thing is very much. Even if we go 10 rounds, we will not finish it. Let's go and tell the king, because if we continue to see like something terrible may happen to us. Who has read the story? Allow people to be bad in you so that you may save them. But if you control everything, you will end up having no more. I have made some choices. I take certain gambles. I gamble. I can destroy the work in the whole nation by the kind of person I set. That's a risk. And it is a risk that has already happened. There are some 2 or 3 nations in which we have damaged the work there by the person we sent there. But it is still better to shame us.
Hallelujah.
In the next 2 years, I want to have 100 assistants. 100 people who can do what I can do. Brahman is going to be one of my assistants for the school of knowing and serving God. I want to use his gifts beyond the narrowness of Nigeria. But Obon is going to be one of my assistants. I already have 3 ministries that are shortlisted for Obon. I thank God. I thank the Nigerian Air Force for retiring him while he is this strong. He is a nation opener. We shall plan for him to open other nations, other than Pakistan. Secondly, he is a general. I shall plan, and he planted an assembly in the Air Force base when he was in Enugu. I want him now. What he did spontaneously out of love for Jesus, I want him to now sit down as a general. Ask for permission to preach in all the officers' mess all over Nigeria and make disciples. Bring in a certain caliber of people into the work. What was once done spontaneously, now we plan it now as ministry in an organized way. Thank you. Clap for me. Person, and if you don't know how to use it, the person, you can have treasure there, you don't even know how to use the treasure.
Yes.
He's not an evangelist. But it's what he did in the Air Force base in Enugu. That was the hand of God upon him. Now that he's free, why should he not do it
How many airport bases are there all over the nation?
Do you think a retired general will ask for permission to preach in the officer's mess in any airport base in the nation and over the
nation?
He should go to preach where his value is acknowledged. Where they know his value. Because they know that this is an air commodo. So that when he enters, the people start standing at attention. Say amen. So we hear the gospel very well. Even respect will force them to hear the gospel. That is the best environment for you to preach the gospel. It's not waste the same time to read so like the rest of you. If he goes to the street, I used to carry my disciples to the street, especially the proud ones. When Daddy Okoro became my disciple, he used to say, all churches apart from CMFI are not serious. So, to cure him of all the criticism of other churches, I took him out for personal evangelism in the quarter. That's the best way to cure over religious people from too much pride. We landed in the who is there? Hello, we are pastors and missionaries. We would like to share the gospel with you. Holy shit. I'm hungry, doctor. This man, the fire of God cannot fly to the mouth. Since you believe, you have never had any persecution written in your book of suffering in heaven. Thank God for this insult that will be recorded at least in your book of suffering in heaven. What it means is that Jesus says, when they reject you in this house, go to the next house. Or you are left, go to the next house. Go to the next house. By the time I have carried him, be thoroughly insulted in many houses. It silences his mouth. That's the best way to transform. When we inherit religious people as disciples, people who have been to many churches, and you want to cure them very fast, to overthrow all the plenty religion they have, carry them out of personal evangelism. No more crusade. No more crusade. House to house evangelism. On street evangelism in the marketplaces. I tell you, when the people have insulted very thoroughly, you see, out there on the street, you cannot say, I am senior librarian in the University of Ibadan. You know, their rank does not matter there. When you even say, I am a missionary, they say, only. You want to come and spy our house in order to come back and sleep in the night. Holy! Your wrath does not matter then. I tell you, personal evangelism can wash you of all your greatness. Praise the Lord. Only the anointing of the Holy Ghost will follow you on the road. True or false? That's the way I used to cure those who are very religious. Carry them to the street. Then my work is easier. After that, my work is easier. I allow unbelievers to insult them until I will not be the one to insult them. If I've never taken you down to the street for personal evangelism, maybe I need you. So that they should give you some thorough insult until you become a Christian. Say amen. The last thing I want to say, then I'll go on break. have applied what I shared with you before from this John chapter, from this 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I've applied it. I am doing a test application in the church in Douala. Our church in Douala has about 7,000 members. When I went from Nigeria, there were about 35 elders or bishops. Of the 35, 12 were already ordained by brother. So after teaching them for 3 years, I dismissed all the other elders except the 12. Because I told them, for me to ordain anybody as an elder, he must also be an overseer. That means you must have the work of others that you are overseeing. So I told them, every overseer must have a minimum of 400 people. So that I can be sure that you are overseeing the work of 4 leaders of 100. Then we'll lay down. So that the word elder and bishop does not become meaningless. I gave them 2 years. They did do it. So I sat. I told all of them to go back to their former elders who had recommended them to become elders and work with them. So they formed what they call family. So we told the families, you are free to meet. Plan your conquest of the city. From the offerings, tithes and offerings that come from your, all the tithes and offerings from all your families, that from these 12 elders, all the tithes and offerings will get to the office of the leader, that's the coordinating leader, Brahmatic Patelet. When they all get there, the financial secretary we divide the tithes and offering from all the families into 75% for the whole church and 25% for that family. From that 25%, they have to break bread and the elder is to be put on the salary. And if they want to build a hall, they have to plan to build their hall from that 25%. But I told them that I'll give them 1 year. 1 year of giving all the elders, all the 12, 100,000 naira francs yearly. That's 35,000 naira as allowance for all the 12 elders. And I told them I'll give you 1 year to make sure that your family, those under you, that the 25% is above the 100 I'm giving you. And enough to break bread. And as their church grows, and as the offerings grow, the 25%, we shall increase your salary based on that 25%. As of now, some families, their 25% is almost 2 million. While some families, their 25% is about 60,000 francs. When December comes, we shall stop the subvention. Those whose 25% is about 2 million, I will put them on a salary of 5 million now. So that I may obey this passage. You shall not muzzle an ox while it is treading the corn. It means that they have a lot of work. After you told them, so if you have your friend there in Douala and you told them, you will be the way after who cut them out. When January comes, I will have a retreat again. I will give instructions to the financial sector that those who 25%, who are going to see the rest, those who 25% is above 2 million. The salary of the head of the family, that is the elder, will be 500,000. The 75% that they put for the whole church, I told them to divide that one into two. 60% of that 75%, they are to send to Kume for World Congress. 40% of that 75%, they are to keep for the conquest of the city of Douala. That means for allowances and buildings and development. So the total, if the total of the 100%, 25% for the family, that for that local, the locality and all those people, then another 30%. For city conference and approximately 45% for work. That is what I would like to do in Nigeria. I wanted to start it in Nigeria. Because that is the Bible means for the support of the worker from the church. We have mentioned other means of support. This is support from the churches. The support from the churches should be tied to the work. But the support from the churches, you are not the one who collects it, say that you are the Levite. Then you collect it and swallow it. It will kill you. Because you have already stolen the ministry by stealing all the money. If the money belongs to the whole ministry and then you use all of it, then you are just lying that you are Christian missionary fellowship. The truth is that you have started your own ministry while using us. That's why you use all the money. If the money was the money of our ministry, will you use all of it without asking our permission? If it is our ministry, then how come you are using all the money? Who gave you the right for it? So you are in peace. Shall God bless this? Does God bless only this? The Hophni and the sons of Eli, they were called Hophni and Phinehas. Were they blessed? They were judged. They were judged for touching the offering. And any of the missionaries who does not fear touching the offering will be judged. They touched the offering and they touched the women. And God told them, what will happen to you will be a sign. Don't touch the offering, because one day you will touch the women. Hophni and Phinehas will judge for touching the offering. And for touching the women. The women who will worship. That's what I've started with Douala. As the Lord blesses, I am going to do it increasingly. In those churches where the leaders are disciplined and where they function under authority, there are some churches that don't even care about us. So if they don't make, if they they don't ask my opinion, or if they don't need my leadership to guide them,
I will not trouble them. I will allow them to continue eating the money on the first credit.
Money, God's money is not one of the things anybody should touch.
I don't call to anybody who is eating God's money.
You will be sorry he ever touched God's money.
Your children will become nothing.
God normally should bless your children so that when you are older, they will take care of you. When you start touching God's money, your children will become normal. God will make sure that the way you treated God as his child, you were God's child, and you took your father's money, you will see your children never send you anything. What you sow, you shall be. Who has understood me? Practice it. It will take a long time. But one day you shall see it in your children. Instead of sending you something, they will eat it. Praise the Lord.